are talking Thanksgiving holidays and how do we survive without feeling deprived. Well, tonight is night three and I've got a biggie for you because I know this is one that's gonna hit home with a lot of you. Cocktails, party time, what do we do? What if you really want that glass of wine or cocktail? How can you not feel that you're missing out? Well, I've got a couple of great suggestions for you. First of all, do know that if you're on a paleo program or you're on a program where carbs are your concern, but not so much calories, a lot of spirits that are out there are carb-free, vodka being one of them. Believe it or not, whiskey is one of them as well, and I believe rye is too. So you can, you know, moderately indulge in them and be okay with that. But if you're on a program like Optavia where alcohol is not allowed and you're really watching carbs and calories and of course your sugars, how do you have a fun beverage and still feel like you're part of the crowd? Well, two big ingredients are going to be your friends, and that is flavored seltzer waters and stevia. Between those two things, you can really make a world of flavors and a world of ideas. And there's one more secret ingredient that I'm going to share with you as time goes on, so stay with me. All right, so your flavored waters, right? Now, when you look out there, there's all kinds of flavors, but I do want to warn you, okay, because there are some things that are called flavored waters that are full of artificial sweeteners or that are full of chemicals or actually have sugars in them. So please, please, please read your labels. Now, otherwise, there are a lot of great beverages that are out there that are completely calorie-free, that don't have any sweeteners in them whatsoever, but you can make sweet yourself. There are a lot of great flavored stevia drops out there, and you can take the flavored seltzer water and add it to flavored stevia drops, or even just the plain stevia drops, and combine the two of them together for some great flavors. For example, what about strawberry seltzer water with lemon flavored stevia? So you've got like a strawberry lemonade, or mango with orange, or gosh, you know, the sky's the limit. There's peaches, there's berries, there's all kinds of citrus flavors out there. I think I even saw pineapple and coconut with LaCroix flavored waters the other day. So there's a lot of fun things you can play with out there. But here's the thing, don't feel you have to put them in a soda, you know, or a glass, you know, regular glass. Go ahead and break out the stemware, right? Put them in a pretty glass. And you know what as well? You can also, for yourself and your guests, go ahead and freeze some fresh fruit. So cranberries are great, blueberries are great, strawberries are great. Freeze them on a cookie sheet and use them as ice cubes in there. If you're on program and you don't want to eat the fruit, that's okay. They can just hang around in the bottom of your glass and look pretty. And they really do dress up a glass and make them look absolutely beautiful. Now, I said I was going to share one other secret ingredient with you. Well, I completely and totally by accident stumbled on something that was really, really decadent. I made a pot of tea the other day, and I left tea bag steeping in the pot a little bit too long, and this happened to be a lemon flavored tea. So it made super, super, super concentrated tea in the bottom of the pot. And I thought, what would happen if I added that to the seltzer? Would that taste okay? Because, you know, you're looking any way you can to flavor up the water. So I poured the intense lemon flavor of the tea into the seltzer water, and oh my gosh, it was so good. So you can definitely play with teas as well. So for example, say you love the flavor of apple cider, but you know, apple cider is loaded with sugar. There's a lot of apple cider tea bags out there. Make a real good concentrate of apple cider tea and pour it into some seltzer, and you almost have like a fuzzy seltzer or a fuzzy cider or a hard cider, which could taste really good. You can again take the tangerine, or there's some hibiscus flavored teas, or lots of different herbal type of teas that are out there that you can mix and come up with some really fun concoctions. So you don't have to feel deprived. You don't need the alcohol, although you may need it to put up with your in-laws, but you know, I digress. And maybe not. Maybe your in-laws are awesome like mine are. Well, I kind of don't really have in-laws per se, but you know what I mean. So if you want to indulge, if you want to have some fun, then concoct up different ways. Don't feel that you're stuck in a box. There's all kinds of things out there that you can play with and completely and totally enjoy this Thanksgiving season while staying on program, meeting your goals, and not feeling deprived. If you like this video, please go ahead and share it with your friends, because there's a lot of information here for everybody. And of course, if you'd like some more ideas, tips, techniques, recipes, just go over over to the website at StaceyHawkins.com. Last but not least, if you're not already part of our newsletter list, please click the link below. Bandit Outback says woof woof. Definitely sign up and you'll be on our newsletter list and get some great recipes on Saturdays usually, as well as a recap of this video series. I'm Stacey Hawkins. Tip number 3. Who knew? Have a great night, everybody. Bye.